from home, but they looked different now. In front of them was a colossal market filled with several stalls and rampaging animals. Slowly, Thomas advanced through the noise at market. As he was walking, he noticed the heaps of hay, cobblestone, and animal dung scattered on the boreal floor. Out of the blue, he heard a man shouting, "Freshly baked bread! Come and get your freshly baked bread!" Thomas jumped at the satisfying thought of warm bread and sped over to the stall rapidly. Unfortunately, he tripped over a huge piece of cobblestone and fell headfirst into a pile of hay. As he stood up, he rubbed his head gently. He immediately rushed to the store, only to see one more piece of bread. He asked the man for the bread, but he immediately experienced the feeling of not having the money he needed, until he remembered he had £5 in his pocket, so he grabbed them out and showed them to the man.
Henry Gates was born in 1491. Young Henry enjoyed a life of pleasure. He enjoyed poetry, dancing, horseback riding, and hunting and killing.
All hail King Henry and his son, who's also named Henry.
Now, my dear, I'm very old now. I want you to make a promise.
No problem. Anything for you, Father.
Carry on this wonderful family's name by having the son who will then be king to carry on the great Tudor name.
But don't I need a wife, sir?
Oh, yes, I forgot about that. In that case, take her part. She used to be a brother Arthur's wife, but now he has gone to have her.
Okay.
Wow. I'm so glad to be married to the king.
Here we have Henry, and he seems to like another woman. Are you happy with it?
No, Catherine can't give me a son. I want a divorce. I want a son.
Well, you are a member of the Catholic Church. How can you have a divorce?
Then the leader will give me a divorce.
How do you know?
Because the leader of the church is me.
So Joseph Lincoln was made and Henry VIII was the head. He then married wife number two, Annie, to Annie Bolly.
Years have passed since Annie became the second wife of Henry VIII, and there is no sign of the boy.
Why can't I just have a son to take the throne and carry on with Tudors?
Henry liked to play instruments, write songs, and music. It is rumoured that he wrote the famous Tudor song, Vincent, about his marriage with Anne Boleyn.
Henry was so fed up that he beheaded and bought another wife. Enter wife 3, Jane Seymour.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Henry's third wife. You both like each other very much.
Unfortunately, James died 2 weeks after Edward was being born. Oh, poor Henry.
My name's Anne Boleyn. I came from Germany to marry King Henry VIII. Our marriage didn't last very long and we got divorced in 4 months. And he thinks I look like a horse.
So Henry's married and divorced to his fourth wife very quick. By this time, ladies must have been scared to be Henry's next bride.
I'm Captain Howard. You're quite old, Henry, but I'll be nice to marry you.
Oh, this one I'll definitely keep.
I don't think I like Henry very much. I'm only 19 and he's 40. All he does is eat and burp all day. He's gone so enormous too.
In the Tudor times, the rich and the poor ate very differently. The rich would have lots of expensive meat and huge banquets. Banquets are huge feasts where rich and poor people would eat together and drink together. Goblets lay preciously on the tables, and more wine people drank, the larger their talking became. It was impossible to have a conversation with anyone, even if you had wanted to. Men stood around holding candles like proverbial gods, and they lit the room so hot that and stuffy that you could hardly breathe. I wished I could take off my heavy doublet. I ate more than I could manage, and still the food kept coming in like a giant banquet. Salmon and venison and roast beef and stuffed porpoise and crab. Each plate held high above the heads of the servants, as if it was high in value. Another dish appeared. It was a swan stuffed with a goose, inside a duck, and inside that a pigeon, and in the centre a tiny quail. Now what do you eat, poor woman?
I eat lots of things. Let me see what I've got in my bag. I've got turnips, bread, and some more turnips.
Huh, I've
got
boar, chicken, lamb and venison.
The story of Henry's life, he has certainly made an impact on the history with all those wives.
Fools beheaded and died, divorced, beheaded, survived, and Henry VIII were 6 sorry wives, some I say and ruined their lives. Catherine the Crown was one, she failed to give me a son. Divorce beheaded and died.